put my name and number. I left my hobbies out. And on my personal profile, I said you better look out. I'm fast and I'm dynamic. I'm born to rule as well. And if you give me a chance, sir, I'm gonna show you all. So give me a job. There isn't anybody better. Give me a job. I want to be professional like you.
Allora, prima di tutto devo scusarmi con il ragazzo di Alice che ho fatto la battuta, il precedente DVD, dicendo we had an affair, che abbiamo al lavoro, eccetera. We didn't have an affair, ok? We finished, I'll tell you what happened, ti dico cosa è successo. Abbiamo finito il giorno di lavoro molto lungo, we decided to paint the town red, ok? Abbiamo dipinto the town, il paese rosso, che è un modo di dire in inglese, di dire abbiamo dato numeri, abbiamo festeggiato. Tonight I'm going to paint the town red. Stasera dipingo tutto il paese di rosso, vuol dire do numeri, bevo, così. So we painted the town red, è scappato un bacio, così. But it wasn't an affair, okay? To delegate tasks. Delegate, delegare. Task, un task è una cosa da fare, okay? So if you delegate tasks, tu quello che non vuoi fare lo deleghi a una persona sotto di te con la scusa americano che lo stai dando più, hai più confidenza in lui, lo dai più responsabilità, si sente più importante e intanto tu lavori meno. To turn, turn, sempre quel rumore, l'uomo che sta male, ok? To turn, girare. Attenzione, accendere la televisione si può dire in due modi. You turn on the television or you switch on. In Inghilterra si usa più turn. To turn off, spegnere, o to switch off, sempre spegnere. Nel prossimo sketch però lo senti to turn off che riguarda una persona. To turn off o to switch off vuol dire spegnersi, non pensare più di lavoro. Cioè di rilassarti, ecco. To turn on someone, evitala a tutti i costi nel lavoro. Lo dico perché è importante. If you turn someone on, lo fai scaldare in un modo che non ha il posto al lavoro. Ci sono mille canzoni inglesi che giocano su queste cose. I'll do anything to turn you on. Farei qualsiasi cosa per accenderti. Vuol dire accenderti, ok? Alla latino, se vuoi. Burn out. Ok, burn out. Sempre l'uomo che sta male, quel fonetico lì. To burn, bruciare. To burn out insieme vuol dire spegnersi. Questo è brutto. To burn out, sostantivo, è proprio non ce la fai più. Stai andando contro un esaurimento nervoso, non ce la fai più veramente, è un esaurimento. E questo può succedere quando lavori troppo. Se tu pensi, se tu lavori tutto il giorno, vai a casa e pensi solo al lavoro, rischi, you're taking a chance, ricordi? To take a chance, rischi, rischiare, you're taking a chance. You risk a burnout. Don't burn out, non spegnerti. To get rid of, un'altra phrasal verb, molto, molto importante, spazzare via, eliminare. To get rid of stress, eliminare lo stress. Ci sono tanti modi di fare, rilassare, hobby, yoga, reading, just turn off. L'ultimo, c'è una confusione in italiano spesso di remember and remind. Allora, to remember è di ricordare una cosa dal passato. To remind è una cosa di far venire in mente a qualcuno. Quindi, I must Please remind me about the party. Fammi venire in mente, ricordami la festa, ma in inglese sarebbe fammi venire in mente che c'è questa festa. So to remind è far venire in mente. To remember è ricordare una cosa passata. Sono diversi. Perché tante volte in italiano dicono tipo, invece di remind me about the party, dicono remember me the party, che vuol dire ti ricordi di me la festa. It doesn't make sense, so avoid it. And now I'm very proud, sono molto orgoglioso, to present, come on, lo sai, Man at Work.
Cocco e una punta di cannella. Hey, painting the town red last night, where are you? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm just so tired. Do you know what time I got home last night?
No.
9:00, and then had to be up at 6:00 this morning to get the train. I don't think I can take much more of this.
Tragedy.
Stop! Andrea, tragedia. Tu sei una tragedia. Ma non vedi com'è messa, poverina? Devi dirle che non può lavorare così tanto, ok? Devi dire che deve delegare di più, deve dare del lavoro, delle responsabilità anche agli altri, sì. Ok? Ci siamo, va bene, dai. Solo a gente, però, di cui può fidarsi.
Sì, lo stavo per dire.
Lo dici?
Sì.
Ok. Azione.
Sandra, you can't burn the candle at both ends. You need to delegate tasks more. You can't do everything yourself. Give other people responsibilities, but choose people who you know are competent.
I know you're right. I've got no time. No time to meet new clients. No time to develop the business.
No time for yourself, first of all. Relax. Relax. Relax!
Okay, calm down.
No, you relax. You must learn to say no.
I know, you're right.
Hello.
But all I can do is sleep.
Nina, nana, nina, oh. Questa inglese a chi la do?
Stop! Cosa stai facendo?
Don't touch my hair, okay? You didn't need to touch my hair.
Rilassati, eh.
Allora, dille di rilassarsi.
Gliel'ho detto.
Allora, tu devi dirle che non può lavorare così, che non è produttiva per la ditta se è stressata e se è stanca. Ok, devi dirle che deve andare in vacanza.
Sì.
Ok?
Io lo dico.
Ce la fai?
Io lo dico.
Ok, vai.
Azione!
No, azione sì. Lo dico io. Azione!
Yeah, you're right. I've got no time. No time to meet new clients. No time to develop the business. All I can think about is sleeping.
Get up!
Don't touch my hair, okay? Ma dire di smettere di toccarmi i capelli!
Dai, smettila di toccarle i capelli.
Ma che attrice sei, che non posso neanche toccarti i capelli. E quando dobbiamo fare la scena d'amore, allora, perché scena 9, scena d'amore sotto la doccia, cioè che sia...
Che cosa?
No.
Che cosa? Sì. Senti, io non mi bagno i capelli per nessuno, eh.
Azione!
Yes, you're right. I've got no time. No time to meet new clients, to develop the business. All I can think about is sleeping.
Sandra, you need a break.
Can't. I've so much to do.
But you are no good to the company if you are so tired and stressed. Go to a spa. Get a massage, relax, turn off for a while, you have a responsibility to be well for you and for us. Look at you. You're stressed. You look old. Your hair looks terrible.
Non è vero, dai, sì, non c'è, dai, questo, guarda, del copione.
Guarda qua. Azione.
You are a victim of your success. The more you do, the more the bosses expect. You are not a robot. You will burn out. Go to your boss and explain that in order to be productive, you have to get rid of the stress. Explain to him that less is more. If you work less hours, you can do more. Explain this to him.
I think you're right.
Listen. Get a coffee with your boss and tell him that you can't contribute as you would like because you are so run down and overstretched. Eh? Tell him that if he can't cut your hours, he can get you an assistant, maybe an intern, so the cost could be low. Take a weekly plan with you, show him a new system of working hours that will give you more time to relax, and remind your boss that if you burn out, they could lose you for a long time. Stress is the number one health problem that costs company money. Take it seriously. Stress is a illness, okay?
Sì, ma se dorme.
Perché non le hai tirato i capelli?
Si arrabbia.
Cutlery sarebbe posate. You've got a spoon, a knife, ignora la cappa, and a fork, bello lungo, se lo dici troppo corto, rischi di dire un'altra cosa. So, fork, è come beach, è sheet, ma beach, spiaggia, lenzuola, foglia di carta, sheet, sempre, guarda, piuttosto falla da mezz'ora, piuttosto fare lungo che corto, perché rischi, figura, ecco. To ask someone out on a date, un appuntamento romantico is a date. Spesso sento gli italiani dicono I have a date with my doctor, e dico, ah, okay, date, tonight I'm out on a date. Sono fuori per un incontro romantico. Appuntamento è un'altra cosa importante, perché è un mezzo false friend questo, perché in inglese appointment è solo ufficiale, lavoro, dottore, callista. Comunque, appointment è veramente ufficiale e formale. You don't have an appointment with your friends. Non esiste un appointment con... è troppo formale, solo formale in inglese. E in realtà non usiamo nessuna parola per sostituirle. I'm going to see my friends. I'm seeing my friends. Azione programmata. Stasera, I'm seeing my friends. To upset. Verbo. To upset vuol dire fare... non incavolare. È un misto tra incavolare e intristire. Se tu sei triste e arrabbiato con me perché ti ho... I've upset you. If I upset you, ti faccio... ti sto antipatico. Dico qualcosa o faccio qualcosa che non ti sta bene e ce l'hai con me. You're upset. Però è interessante questo, perché in italiano è proprio o triste, arrabbiato, è proprio misto. Sono arrabbiato e triste perché you have upset me. E tutte queste parole li vedi in A New Dawn.
Shh! I think she's got fleas. Oh no, it's a nut. Oh. Mm. So, did you sort things out with Jennifer?
Yeah, we're fine now. Hey, guess what? Today, she taught me to carry 6 plates on my arms.
Wow, 6?
And the boss bought more cutlery. So that's sorted out now. Oh, thanks for that.
So, what's wrong?
Well, I had a chat with the boss about lack of cutlery and conditions and so on. He was really nice about it. In fact, too nice.
Too nice?
Yeah, he was acting strange today. He kept coming up close and paying me compliments. Oh, he's never done that before.
Oh, I see.
At first, it was just silly things, you know. Comments about my hair and shoes. But then he asked me out on a date.
Go on.
Then in my break time, he kept coming up to me and started putting his arms around me.
And what did you do?
Well, what could I do, Mum? He's the boss. I don't want to be rude. I mean, since I had a chat with Jennifer, things are sorted out. I like my job. I like having a job. But he's the boss. I don't want to upset him.
Listen, you must stop this now. When he comes up close, make sure you've got a tray or a bowl of hot soup. That'll keep him at a distance and it'll send him a message. If he doesn't understand then, mention that you have a new boyfriend, even if it isn't true.
Oh, Mum, he's not going to be bothered about that. He's married with 3 kids.
Ah, well, in that case, ask him about his wife and kids. Tell him you think how lucky he must be to have a lovely little family to go home to. Talk to his better nature.
Maybe it's just better if I get another job.
Hey, no, why should you? That's not fair.
Oh, look, Mum, I don't want to talk about this now, OK? I'm really tired. Can we talk in the morning?
Mm. Mm.
Good night, Mum.
Good night.
Good night. OK, everybody's been served, I think, Mr. Giles.
Wow. Well, lucky customers, eh? Great food, lovely young waitress serving them, eh? Isn't it about time you had a break?
No, I don't think I'll have a break today. You know, there's so many customers in. And...
Oh, come on, Dawn. You've got to have a break. Perhaps we could just, you know, me and you, we could pop over for a coffee, go over the road there and, you know, I'm sure...
No, really. I'm afraid my boyfriend might see us. Yeah, he works nearby.
Your boyfriend?
Yeah, we've only been seeing each other for a couple of days, but I really like him.
Don't worry, I won't get jealous.
Yeah, but I bet your wife is.
My wife? No. You see, we're having a few problems, you see. She just doesn't understand me anymore, yeah? Oh!
Hello, pretty boy. What's the special today? Is it you?
No, it's carrot soup.
Wondered whether you might like to pop across the road to have a cup of coffee with me. Just you and me.
Well, there's no need. We do coffee here.
Well, you like me, don't you?
Listen, I'm married.
Oh, Dawn, do you hear that? He's married. He wouldn't dream of being disloyal to his lovely wife. Do you have kids?
Well, yeah, 3.
Oh, he's got kids. They must be so proud to have such a loyal father.
Mum, could you leave us alone for a minute, please?
Mum?
Listen, Mr. Giles, I really like you and I really respect you, but... I prefer to keep our relationship professional, if that's okay with you.
Look, I was just admiring you.
Yeah, but I'd prefer it if you admired me in silence from now on.
I understand. But can I ask you one question?
Yeah, of course.
Your mum? Can you keep her away from me?
Yeah, all right, I'll try.
It's finished, the pasta! Where is?
Oh, I love it when you get angry.
Stay away from me!
Dawn, have you finished?
It's your sister! You never told me you had a sister. I call you.
Oh, yes. Oh, please do. Oh. Hello, you.
Hi. Enzo, non è ici.
Oh, you don't need Enzo now.
No.
So, how are you?
Okay, ma Enzo...
You didn't answer my email. Is everything okay?
Okay. Fotocopia.
I mean, I know I was a bit forward, but you can answer me now.
Kiss my face.
Andrea, you Italians are so passionate. I mean, we can't not hear. But how about my house tonight? Hello.
Hello. Cioè, non sai una parola di inglese, già hai cuccato due inglesi, ma io non lo so come fa...
Tre. Anche David della contabilità.
David della contabilità.
Hey.
Hi.
Are you ready to take me to lunch, sweetie?
Ok. Vieni pure tu.
No, no, ho già mangiato, grazie.
Ti offro un caffè.
No, prima di mangiare sai che il caffè è proprio... magari un'altra... Non sai cosa è disposto a fare Andrea pur di mantenere il posto. Allora ti spiego.
Mi hai chiamato?
No.
Vuoi un caffè?
No, sai che prima di mangiare il caffè non...
Ti faccio le fotocopie.
Prima di mangiare le fotocopie mi rimangono sempre...
Enzo, mettiti nei miei panni.
Una volta, la prossima volta, sicuro, siamo amici, no?
Ok.
Buon divertimento.
Ciao,
ciao. Ok. Allora, cioè tu non ci credi, tu non ci puoi credere. Allora, hai presente David?
Qualche modo di dire inglese che li troverai nel prossimo sketch. We're off to, dicono. Allora, c'è un film che io amavo con tutto cuore da bambino, che era Mago di Oz, che in inglese è The Wizard of Oz. E quando erano lì tutti e quattro, no? L'uomo di acciaio, il leone, l'uomo di fieno e lei, il cagnolino. E loro cantavano We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz. Bellissimo. Io aspettavo Natale solo per quel film lì. I loved it. We're off to vuol dire we're going. Stiamo andando a. We're off to. Stiamo andando a. E mi sembra che l'attrice dice We're off to the Bahamas o qualcosa. Stiamo andando a Bahamas. Poi nowadays. È tutto attaccato. Nowadays. Nowadays vuol dire che c'è dentro ora, giorno, vuol dire al momento, oggi, in questi tempi, li senti gli anziani inglesi che dicono una volta con una stellina potevi comprare i fish and chips, portare i tuoi ragazzi al cinema, andare poi a prendere la pizza, no perché non esisteva, andare a discoteca, prendere il taxi a casa e ancora avere i 20 pence di resto. Nowadays, with £1, con una stellina, non puoi nemmeno comprare le caramelle. So nowadays, nel lavoro, si dice, una volta si lavorava così. Nowadays, we do it like this. The world of business is changing all the time. To pop out, fare un salto fuori. To pop into, I'm just popping into the pub. L'inglese lo dicono tutti gli uomini. Listen, I'm just popping into the pub. Faccio un salto, tra parentesi breve, al pub. Poi arrivo alle 3 di notte nella casa di qualcun altro perché non ti ricordi nemmeno dove abiti. Oh, this is in England it's normal, okay? To overhear. To overhear. To hear è sentire con l'orecchio. To overhear è sentire qualcosa per sbaglio. Magari parlano vicino e you overhear. Sì, vabbè, questa è solitamente la scusa per chi mette il becco. Dico, oh, I hear, passato heard. L'uomo che sta male, I overheard. Oh, I overheard them saying blah blah blah. Ho sentito per sbaglio che hanno detto blah blah blah. So to overhear, sentire non appositamente. Canteen, false friend, false friend. Canteen non è cantina, ma canteen è mensa. Flirt, uomo che sta male, te l'ho detto, è ovunque. To flirt, sarebbe flirtare, perché l'ho sentito in italiano. Sono stato anche accusato parecchia volta. Perché flirti con la cameriera? Ho solo chiesto se c'hanno la bistecca. Ok, lo chiedo io, chiedeli tu. Flirt, ok? To flirt, sostantivo, if you're a flirt, sei uno che fa un po' il marpione. If you flirt, verbo, vuol dire che fai farfallone. Altri accusi che ho avuto, ingiustamente. E tutte queste ingiustizie lo sentiremo adesso in Madame Chantier.
So is it a whale, a fish, or a mammal?
A mammal.
What?
A mammal!
Perfect.
Does your mother know you come here every day to do your homework? Does she know you're a cheat?
She's the one who sent me here. She's your customer, you should know that.
I know.
She's the one who comes here to ask you for the lottery numbers. So she cheats, and you help her cheat, so...
Okay. Next question.
How much does an elephant drink in a day?
Indian or African?
Indian.
As much as it can.
As much as it can. All right, that'll do for today. See you in a few weeks. We're off to the Bahamas.
Really? Lucky you.
Yes, I know I am lucky. And it's all thanks to you.
Thanks to me?
Yes, those numbers you gave my mum. She won 5 million.
What?
The final question. Should I wear a bikini or a full
suit? Get out!
Oh dear.
Oh, and the whale is a mollusk. Hi, Jack.
Hello, dear.
What do you want?
What do I want? I'll tell you what I want. I want some peace.
What's wrong?
I have a new boss.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and she's a woman.
Oh, is she pretty?
Yeah, she is. But that's not important.
I think it is, Jack. If you're not pretty nowadays, nobody loves you. You just wait in his garden at night, looking through the window, hoping to see him undress. And what does he do? Oh, what? Oh, he calls the police? Again? People are so superficial, Jack. Especially the police.
Yeah. Oh. Anyway, I've been having a series of business meetings at Semico recently with my new boss, Cheryl, because the company is expanding into the Far East and China. And sometimes, not always, but sometimes, those meetings go on late into the night and...
But blah, 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 blah. What does she want?
Well, she often pops into my office to have a chat about work. Oh, that's perfectly understandable. I mean, one does, doesn't one, anyway. But sometimes it just seems like a pretext or an excuse. And I've also noticed that she's been dressing in a more provocative way recently. You know, the sort of thing. Short skirts, high heels. And she sometimes wears a little extra perfume.
Well, Jack, if you maybe just concentrate a bit more on your job, you wouldn't notice all these things.
Then, when she comes into the office sometimes, she puts a hand on my arm or leg if we're sitting close to each other.
Oh, poor Jack. That must be horrible for you.
No. No, not at all, actually.
Oh, Jack, it's horrible for you.
No, I'm quite flattered. I'm quite flattered. All that attention.
Oh, God, it's horrible.
Anyway, my colleagues have noticed what's happening. This is the problem. And sometimes I've overheard them making snide remarks when I've been leaving the lift or queuing up for the canteen.
Listen, you have to put some distance between yourself and Cheryl. Huh? For example, you could come to work a bit earlier in the morning so you don't have to stay late.
Yeah, okay. Good idea.
Yeah. Oh, let me see. Where my eyes don't see, the third eye will be. I see a woman. She's your boss. Oh! She's old and a bit pathetic, to be honest. Oh, she's wearing a short skirt which makes her look ridiculous. Oh, yes, Jack, look at that. She's ridiculous.
Okay.
Oh, my God. I see your colleagues laughing at you. Oh, look, Jack. Oh, look at Jack. Look, Jack smiling to the old woman with the stupid skirt.
Okay. I've understood. All right.
Oh, you must be professional. Never have an affair with your boss. If one day things go wrong, which they will, Jack, because they will, then your life is finished.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Now go, Dai. Go. Go, Jack.
Okay. Thanks again.
Sta zoccola.
Hello.
They say you know everything.
Yes, I do. I know everything. What do you want?
I need to know how I can seduce the man I love.
Well, have you tried standing in his garden at night?
No.
Good. Don't try it. Doesn't work.
The problem is, I'm his boss.
La prossima puntata è una delle più importanti perché è il telefono. C'è un inglese abbastanza specifico su telefonare, ma anche abbiamo fatto tante cose per farti anche aiutare a capire una persona al telefono. But first, I would like to introduce the wonderful Silky Steve Band. Delicate. It's a delicate thing. I don't believe that you should ever mix professional relationships with personal relationships. And at the moment, I have this problem because there's a lady where I work called... I'll tell you her name because it's the name of the song. Her name is Bruna.
Bruna Tortelli?
Yeah, how did you... Come hai fatto sapere?
Lavori con Bruna Tortelli.
Yes. What's funny? Fa ridere anche a me.
Racconta.
Anyway, she's a very sweet, very nice woman, but she leaves little messages and she wears a lot of perfume and mini skirts and I find it...
E qual è il problema?
Because we're trying to work there. Stiamo lavorando lì, non siamo in discoteca, capito? Cioè io sono nuovo lì, voglio concentrare e lei mi disturba sempre, capito? I'm not interested in any relationship apart from a professional relationship. I'm professional. Do you know what that means? Tu sai cosa vuol dire essere professionista?
Sì.
Sì, eh? Ti ricordi magari un po'. So this is for you. Bruna Tortelli.
Bruna Tortelli, I am just your colleague. Just send the file, go back to your office. And if you call me up, don't tell me that you love me. Just ask me things about the orders coming. Bruna, close your heart today. I really need to concentrate. Bruna, you're very sweet, I'm sure. But I just want to work no more. Bruna Tortelli, I see you as a worker. And nothing more. Don't take this any further, or I won't have to tell the boss and there'll be problems. He needs to know why nothing's getting done now. Bruna, close your heart today. I really need to concentrate
myself.
Bruna, you're very sweet, I'm sure.
So sweet, I'm sure.
I just want to work no more. Solo.
Close your heart.
I really need to concentrate.
I really need.
Bruna, yeah, very sweet, I'm sure.
You're very sweet.
But I
just
want to work no more.
Quando canti devi sempre esagerare, eh?
Give me a job. There isn't any